President of Peru. It's an honor for me, President Toledo, to see you today. As I'm going to say, you started one of the most important changes in your region, particularly in your country, opening the economy and the markets. The last years, my dear friends, probably you have heard this expression. This is the decade of Latin America. And in some sense, that could be true. In the first decade of this 21st century, Latin America grew more than other regions in the world, with the exception of Asia. And some of our countries grew at an amazing rate of growth, in particular in South America. And this happened despite the fact that the United States faced the worst economic crisis since the big crisis from 1929. Despite the fact that the Eurozone started the worst crisis in its very young history. So, what is the reason for that? What happened in Latin America? What is happening today? In particular, what do we need to do in order to maintain that kind of phenomenon and make real not only past decade but also this decade as the decade of Latin America? Let me say that our region has a lot of capabilities. Very young people, a lot of natural resources, as always, let me say. But in particular, last decade, there was a very important economic phenomenon in the world, which was the increment in the price of commodities, and in particular, in the price of food. According to the data of FAO, the prices of commodities rose 200, that's last line. I would prefer to control that from this place. But that slide shows the way in which Latin American countries grew beyond the rest of the world economy, and of course that implies a very good performance for our region. You can see there, in particular in 2009, the economic crisis, but certainly even in that moment and in the whole decade, Latin American performance was by far better than the rest of the world economy. But let me go back to my point. The last decade, the price of food and commodities rose 240% between 2002 and 2011. And that, of course, implied several impacts in different directions. For instance, the increment in commodities and food implied a very painful consequences for a lot of people, billions of people in the world. A lot of phenomena happened related with the price of food. Several crises in the world started at the same time. This painful situation implied, for instance, poverty crisis in the Horn of Africa, and some of them that we thought that will never appear again, and a very important phenomenon which was the increase in extreme poverty around the world. And that is very logical, although you could consider that the poorest people allocate roughly 50% of their income looking for food. And if the food increased 200%, you can imagine such an important impact in poverty around the world. We don't know, not yet, the figures most recent figures probably coming after 2010, but probably last decade implied one of the worst moments in terms of the increase of poverty around the world. However, this painful situation represented a good opportunity for several Latin American economies. That implied that we need to say that the weight of commodity in exports, however, is not the same in all Latin American region. As you can see, the commodities as percentage of the GDP and commodities as export are most concentrated in South America and Central America, including Mexico. So more economies in South America are more dependent on commodity prices and food. And of course, during these years, there were good news in some sense in terms of economic income, in terms of export, in terms of revenues for several economies, big producers of commodities, either minerals, oil, or of course food, grains, which is the case of Brazil or Argentina or Paraguay or Uruguay or other countries in South America. However, the problem with commodities is that commodity prices are very unstable, volatile, and of course absolutely correlated with the performance of the economy in some cases. And as you can see, if it's true that in the first part of this decade, and most of the years of them, the price of commodities went up, the prices stabilized at some point and even started to increase. And for several countries, this means that the bonanza started to stop. And that is probably what is happening today with very big economies, very big producers of commodities, and food in particular, which is the case of Brazil, Argentina, or Paraguay. So the problem with commodities is other as well. Probably one of the most traditional problems of developing countries is this kind of overdependence on export of raw materials. So as long as price stabilized or started to fall, the economic phenomenon of growth started to deter or even deteriorate in several nations. My opinion is that commodity-centered growth is not sustainable. And it is necessary to modernize the economy and insert the economy in the global world. If we analyze the performance of some Latin American economies last year, 2012, you can see several of them registered very high rates of growth, but others more related with commodities export are observing much less economic performance, which is the case of Paraguay with negative growth, Brazil, and Argentina. And in the right side of the graph, Panama, Peru, in particular, Mexico, Chile, and I will include there Colombia. But the point is this. What happened is once the price of commodities stabilized, the performance of the region inside the region started to change. What is going to happen in the future is very difficult to say. But what is clear is that as long as the economy is global today, as long the markets are more interconnected than ever, and that will be the trend in the future, the more Latin America